Algae vary in size, with the smallest single-celled algae being so small that you need a microscope to see them, to many-celled algae that are large enough to see with the naked eye. Microscopic algae that live dispersed in the water are called phytoplankton. Phytoplankton are usually buoyant, free-floating, and move with currents. Some phytoplankton are also individually motile. Although phytoplankton are microscopic, millions of cells together can be seen without a microscope. In fact, hundreds of millions of individual cells can fit in a shot glass. Instead of floating in the water, other microscopic algae can grow attached to surfaces, such as plants and rocks beneath the water. Periphyton is a mat made of algae, bacteria, and other microscopic organisms. Although the individual algae are microscopic, periphyton can be seen as floating mats or growing on plants. Other types of algae are made of multiple cells and can be seen with the naked eye. These are called macroalgae and include seaweed like kelp. Kelp is a type of brown algae that grows on the west coast of the United States. It can grow as tall as a 20-story building under the water. Some types of macroalgae can grow attached to surfaces beneath the water and will float freely in the water if they become detached. Algae require sunlight, water, select nutrients, and carbon dioxide to grow through photosynthesis. Algae absorb sunlight using chlorophyll A and other pigments stored within the algae. Through photosynthesis, algae create sugars called carbohydrates from the dissolved carbon dioxide in the water, giving algae the energy it needs to live and grow. Optimal sunlight is essential for algal growth, but water, especially when it is dirty or brown, reduces the amount of light that reaches algae. To make up for this, algae have photosynthetic adaptations to capture the optimal amount of sunlight. Some algae have additional, different colored pigments to absorb more sunlight through photosynthesis, resulting in different colored algae. These pigments can be especially useful in deeper waters, where there is less sunlight reaching the algae. Some algae have adaptations that help them float near the surface of the water so that they can capture more sunlight. For example, some cyanobacteria have gas-filled structures or pockets called vesicles that are used to regulate buoyancy. When gas builds up in these vesicles, the algae float to the surface of the water. Cyanobacteria move up and down in the water to maximize light and collect nutrients. Most algae passively move with the water currents, but some algae species can swim or move towards light. For example, some green algae detect light with a light-sensing eye spot. They use their flagella to either move toward or away from the light to optimize photosynthesis. Algae require certain nutrients to grow. All algae require nitrogen, phosphorus, and trace elements. Trace elements include several nutrients that are required only in small amounts, such as iron. In addition to these required nutrients, diatoms need silica to form their glass cell walls. Most algae obtain dissolved nutrients from the water, but some cyanobacteria species can fix or convert atmospheric nitrogen into ammonia. This form of nitrogen can then be used by other types of algae. As cyanobacteria die and decay, ammonia is released and can support the growth of other species of algae. In summary, algae vary in size from microscopic to large enough to see with the naked eye. Algae can float in the water or grow attached to surfaces. Most algae require sunlight, carbon dioxide, and nutrients, including nitrogen and phosphorus, to grow through photosynthesis.